Welcome to GD Reddy YouTube channel regarding APIIIT 2020 entrance preparation. I wish you all the best. Hi students, watch my studio videos regularly from the beginning to ending. Don't miss. At the end, we have to like, share, and subscribe my videos. Regularly, and also I request you to share these links to your friends to connect my videos and watch, ask them to watch and like, share and subscribe the my channel. Okay. So far we covered 97 bits in the chapter. So now 98th bit. Once again, I wish you all the best. Share, like, and subscribe my channel. Last work chustune undandi. Chivarlo subscribe cheyandi. Bell icon meeda click cheyandi. Ventane nenu post chesina videos meeku notification lo vastayi. It is easy to watch my videos. Now start the bits. First bit, that is today's first bit. Yolk in just boiled egg. Yolk in just boiled egg. Udakabettina gudlo unnatundi patsa zona anamata. Hotter that while layer because. So lopala patsa zona ekkuva vediga untundi painunna danakante enduku ani. So I have clearly explained the applications of specific heat. There are three applications in our concept key point, but I also explained about these topic also. So the yolk inside the boiled egg, which has specific heat high anamata. So the specific heat of yolk is high. Due to this, it retains its hotness for longer time. Next bit on the screen, if 100 ml of water at 60 degrees C is added to 200 ml of water at 30 degrees C, then the temperature in mixture is. So many bits are repeated. We have already know, see this type of question using methods of mixtures. Mishramala paddhati pai sutram prakaramu ee question manamu sulabhanga answer cheyavachu. Ee mishramala paddhati sutramu. T is equal to M1 T1 plus M2 T2 by M1 plus M2. Here given M1 100 ml, T1 60 degrees C, M2 200 ml and T2 30 degrees C. So substitute in the formula, resultant mixture T is equal to M1 T1 plus M2 T2 by M1 plus M2. You may get the answer 40 degrees C. It is the correct answer. Very good. Next question on the screen. If 20 grams of ice at 0 degrees C is added to 120 grams of water at 49 degrees C, then the temperature of the mixture is. Similarly, if you calculate this question, we get the answer B, 42 degrees C. Then opposite to condensation, opposite is nothing but reverse process of condensation. So what is the reverse process of condensation? Tell me. Yes, you are correct. That is answer D. Evaporation is the reverse process of condensation. Next question on the screen. The sweating of the reason for sweating in Vizag at even though it is cooler than Vijayawada is. So Visakhapatnam lo ekku okkapothaga untundi Vijayawada kanna challaga unnappatiki ni enduku. So when do we get sweat? Where? Yes, if the humidity, that is amount of vapor already present in air, is more, then we get sweat. Here humidity at Vizag is high, so due to higher humidity in Vizag, it is answer B is correct. Next one, 103. Which of the following is possible? Kindi vatle edi sambhavistundi? Answer and options. A bath with 130 degrees C water brings water at 35 degrees C. C did an experiment with 273 K water. All the above. So answer option A is correct. A, baths with 130 degrees C with water. Next one, 104. Boiling can be recognized when? So boiling can be recognized when? Options A, improvement in temperature of liquid stops, decrease in temperature of liquid stops, decrease in temperature of liquid starts after vaporization is completed. So boiling can be recognized. Neeru maragadam eppudu gamanistham? You can already explain during the concept of boiling. During boiling the temperature remains constant. So neeru beaker lo isukuni wait chesthe prarambhamlo temperature perugutu untundi. Once it reached 100 degrees C, 100 degrees C cherukune gudiki tarvata manamu enta వేడి చేస్తున్నా కూడా ఉష్ణోగ్రతలో మార్పు ఉండదు అన్నాం. అప్పుడు వాటర్ బాయిల్స్ అవుతూ ఉంటుంది అన్నాం. కాబట్టి ద ఇంప్రూవ్మెంట్ ఇన్ టెంపరేచర్ ఆఫ్ లిక్విడ్ స్టాప్స్, ఇట్ ఈస్ ద ఆప్షన్ కరెక్ట్. నెక్స్ట్ వన్, 105. సప్లైడ్ హీట్ అండ్ టెంపరేచర్ ఆఫ్ లిక్విడ్ ఇస్ షోన్ ఇన్ ద గ్రాఫ్ ఆన్ ఎక్స్ యాక్సిస్ అండ్ వై యాక్సిస్ రెస్పెక్టివ్లీ, దెన్ ద బాయిలింగ్ పాయింట్ ఆఫ్ వాటర్ ఈజ్. సో హియర్ ఎ లిక్విడ్ ఇస్ టేకన్ and is heated, the heat energy supplied and temperature recorded, a graph is drawn, the graph obtained the curve as shown. So initially if you see that the liquid is at nearly 10 degrees C when heated, that is heat energy supplied, the temperature regularly increases up to 40 degrees C. Once the liquid reaches 40 degrees C, then there is no rise in temperature. So in at this stage there is a change in phase from liquid to gas. So as we can say, the 40 degrees C is the boiling point of liquid. Okay, very good answer. Ahead, keep it up. Chustune unnandi. Next question on the screen. The temperature of the body is proportional to dash of the molecules. So temperature and kinetic energy relation baaga gurtu pettukolma. It is the average kinetic energy of the molecules. Very good. Next question on the screen. The temperature of iron rod is 330 K, then the Celsius. It is the repeated question. So Kelvin lo ichinaru, Celsius lo marchalante em cheppinaam? Subtract 273. So as you are assumption is correct. Many students did correct answer, that is option B is correct, 57 degrees C. Then temperature of the body is proportional to dash energy. It is also repeated question. It is kinetic energy. So average kinetic energy of the molecule is directly proportional to absolute temperature. Next question, the amount of heat energy contained in your body. So amount of heat energy contained in your body ఏమవుతుంది? మా డైరెక్ట్లీ ప్రపోర్షనల్ టు ద మాస్ ఆఫ్ సబ్స్టాన్స్, ఇన్వర్స్లీ ప్రపోర్షనల్ టు మాస్ ఆఫ్ సబ్స్టాన్స్, ఈక్వల్ టు ద మాస్ ఆఫ్ సబ్స్టాన్స్, నన్ ఆఫ్ ద అబౌ. గెస్ ద ఆన్సర్. సో అమౌంట్ ఆఫ్ హీట్ క్యూ డైరెక్ట్లీ ప్రపోర్షనల్ టు ఎం. సో డైరెక్ట్లీ ప్రపోర్షనల్ టు మాస్ ఆఫ్ ద సబ్స్టాన్స్. యు నో దట్ క్యూ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఎంఎస్ డెల్టా టి. సో క్యూ డైరెక్ట్లీ ప్రపోర్షనల్ టు ఎం. నెక్స్ట్ క్వశ్చన్ ఆన్ ద స్క్రీన్. ద అమౌంట్ ఆఫ్ హీట్ ఎనర్జీ గివన్ అవుట్ బై ఎ బాడీ ఈజ్. The amount of heat energy given out by a body is directly proportional to heat energy to its initial temperature, directly proportional to its fall in temperature directly proportional to its final temperature, and none of the above. Guess the answer. Heat energy given out by a hot body. So oka veediga unna vastu usna shaktini kolipothe em avutundi, the temperature taggipothundi, usnagrata taggutundi. So directly proportional to fall in temperature. Option B is correct. Next question on the screen. A table below shows the temperature of P and Q in contact with each other. In which case rate of heat from P to Q is least? So P and Q rendu vastulu veri veri ushnagratalo vadda unnapudu, ai rendu thermal contact lo usne sparshalo unnapudu, rate of heat లో లీస్ట్ ఏ నుండి పి నుండి క్యూకి ట్రాన్స్ఫర్ అయ్యి హీట్ ఎందులో తక్కువగా ఉంటుంది? గెస్ ద ఆన్సర్. హియర్ ఇన్ ద కేస్ ఆఫ్ ఏ ఆప్షన్ టెంపరేచర్ డిఫరెన్స్ ఇస్ 60, ఇన్ కేస్ ఆఫ్ బి ఇట్ ఈస్ 80, ఇన్ సి ఇట్ ఈస్ 40, ఇన్ డి ఇట్ ఈస్ 10. ఈవెన్ దో ఇట్ ఈస్ 10, ద ఆప్షన్ సి ఈస్ కరెక్ట్, ఇన్ విచ్ ద రేట్ ఆఫ్ heat is least. Next question, the specific heat of water in SI system is, specific heat of water in SI system is, here there is no option, it is wrong. So the correct answer is 4186. 4.4186 joules per. So the correct answer is 4186 joule per kilogram Kelvin, kilogram Kelvin. So none of the above. The answer 4186. 4186 joule per kilogram Kelvin. Sometimes it is given 4180 also. Next question on the screen. During daytime, water bodies are cooler than the land masses, because specific heat capacity of the land is. So during daytime, water bodies cooler than the land masses. Kunna water bodies neeru nelakanna takkuga sallaga untundi, enduku? Because the specific heat of land is less than water. You know that water has high specific heat, so land has less specific heat than water. Next question. In the land, breeze blow from land to sea in coastal regions because the land cools slowly as compared to seawater, is heated rapidly as compared to seawater, cools at the same rate as seawater, none of the above. So in the previous question, I say that the specific heat of land is less than that of water. Land yokka specific heat visishtoshnam neeti kante takkuvaga untundi, kaabatti land త్వరగా వేడెక్కుతుంది. సో హియర్ ఈజ్ ల్యాండ్ ఈజ్ హీటెడ్ యాజ్ ర్యాపిడ్లీ యాజ్ కంపేర్డ్ టు సీ వాటర్, ఇట్ ఈస్ ద ఆప్షన్. నెక్స్ట్ క్వశ్చన్ ఆన్ ద స్క్రీన్. వాటర్ ఈజ్ యూజ్డ్ ఫర్ ద ఇంటర్నల్ హీట్ ఆఫ్ బిల్డింగ్స్ బికాస్, వాటర్ ఈజ్ యూజ్డ్ ఫర్ ద ఇంటర్నల్ హీటింగ్ ఆఫ్ బిల్డింగ్స్ బికాస్, ఆప్షన్స్ ఇట్ హ్యాస్ హై స్పెసిఫిక్ హీట్, ఇజ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ కరెక్ట్, its temperature does not rise above 100 degrees, it is also correct, it is cheapest and easily available is also correct. So the option is finally all the above, all the above. So for this the option is all the above. Next question, the heat energy required to change a liquid at its boiling point into gaseous state without any rise in temperature is called. So liquid drava పదార్థాన్ని వాయు స్థితిలోకి మార్చడానికి అవసరమైన ఉష్ణరాశిని ఏమంటారు ద్రవాలు వాయువులుగా కాబట్టి ఇట్ ఈస్ ఎస్ యు ఆర్ కరెక్ట్ ఆప్షన్ ఏ లేటెంట్ హీట్ ఆఫ్ వేపరైజేషన్ నెక్స్ట్ క్వశ్చన్ ఆన్ ద స్క్రీన్ దెర్ ఈస్ 1 gram ఆఫ్ స్టీమ్ అండ్ 1 gram ఆఫ్ వాటర్ 100 degrees C దెన్ సో 1 gram నీటి ఆవిరి ఉంది 1 gram నీరు 100 degrees C వద్ద ఉన్నాయి Which one of the option is correct? You know that steam contains more heat energy. Steam contains more heat energy. Very good. Next question. Melting is a process in which solid phase changes to melting. ద్రవీభవనము అంటే ఏం చెప్పుకున్నాం? ఒక స్థిర ఉష్ణోగ్రత వద్ద ఏదైనా ఒక ఘన పదార్థము ద్రవ పదార్థంగా మారడము. So change of solid phase into liquid phase at constant temperature is defined as the melting point. Option B is correct. Next, 3 bodies A, B, C are in thermal equilibrium. It is also repeated question. So 3 bodies are thermal equilibrium. Usna samata sthitilo unnai. The temperature of B is 45 degrees. What is the temperature of C? So thermal equilibrium. Usna samata sthitilo unte em avutayi. They have at the same temperature. So option A is correct. Next question on the screen. That 2 bodies A and B are in contact from the last 5 hours, then heat transfers from dash A to B, B to A, not sure, no transfer between them. 2 bodies A and B are in contact for the last 5 hours. So if 2 bodies are in contact, immediately there is a transfer of heat between them. They attain thermal equilibrium. But here last 5 hours, 5 gantala paatu unchite em avutayi, both attain thermal equilibrium. Then there is no transfer of heat between them. So the answer D is correct. Next question on the screen. Some water and 270 grams of ice is given. Same amount of heat. When amount of water can be vaporized by the time an ice melts fully. So, some amount of ice undi ento teliyadu illa. Water yokka అమౌంట్ కనుక్కోవాలి మనం అండ్ ఐస్ మాస్ ఇచ్చినాడు సేమ్ అమౌంట్ ఆఫ్ సప్లై చేసినాం వాట్ అమౌంట్ ఆఫ్ వాటర్ కెన్ బి వేపరైడ్ బై ద టైమ్ ఐస్ మెల్ట్స్ ఫుల్లీ అన్నాడు యు నో దట్ క్యూ ఇజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఎంఎల్ సో వాటర్ లేటెంట్ హీట్ ఆఫ్ వేపరైజేషన్ ఆఫ్ వాటర్ ఇస్ 540 So amount of water m into 540 next ice 270 into 80 so if you calculate these we get 40 answer very good nice required heat energy to change the temperature of 1 gram of water from 273 K to 274 K is So here 1 gram of water from 273 K to 274 K. What is the difference in temperature? Rise in temperature only 1 degree C. You know what is meant by specific heat? Specific heat is the amount of energy required to convert 1 gram of water into gas. So specific heat. So specific heat of water is 1 kilojoule in Celsius units. Similarly, in SI units, it is 4.18 joules. So option A and B also correct. Very good. That is option C is correct. So the heat energy required is nothing but specific heat. Here Celsius kilojoule and SI 4 joules. Next one. 1 gram of water at 100 degrees C is heated. 1 gram mass is 1 gram. Heated at 10 degrees C, which is at 10 degrees C, is heated till its temperature rises to 11 degrees. Here also change in temperature is 1 degree C only. 1 gram of mass is given. So unit mass, rise in temperature, 1 unit. The amount of heat energy absorbed by the water is. Ento untundi ma essay? Yes, it is nothing but 1 calorie. Next question on the screen. The graph given in the figure represents a cooling curve of the substances being cooled from a higher temperature to a lower temperature. Let us consider the body is at higher temperature, yeah, 200 degrees C cooled. So generally, let us assume the body is in gaseous state. Gaseous, when cooled, its temperature decreases, reaches to 150 degrees C. There is a phase change from gas to liquid, which is nothing but boiling point. So here, what is the boiling point of the substance? It is 150 degrees C. Next, which one is odd among the following? In the one, where is the heat absorbed, rise in temperature, density of the substance, mass of the substance? So here, C is odd one. So absorbed heat is directly proportional to mass of the substance and change in temperature. Q is equal to ms delta T. Andulo D ane padam le, density padam ledu. Kaabatti D is the odd one. Veruga unnadi edante density of the substance. Last question today's: formation of dew is an example for dew. Tusaram erpadam deniki udaharana? Tell me. Yeah, it is condensation. In the definition of dew, the water droplets condensed on the surfaces, hence it is the condensation. Okay, wish you all the best. Chustune undandi first nunchi chivaru varaku, chudandi, subscribe cheyandi, like cheyandi, share cheyandi, friends ni kuda like chesi share chese vidhanga meeru cheyandi. Okay, thank you, bye, good.